When Christmas trees started coming ashore here in Pentwater, Michigan, the world knew that the Christmas tree ship was lost and Captain Santa would never make port. The Lake Seamen's Union offered to collect trees here and in Two Rivers, Wisconsin, to hopefully put together some money and sell these trees in Chicago to pay off some of the debts that the Schuneman family had incurred.
The Simmons was watched by lifesavers as it passed Kewaunee, Wisconsin, but then it vanished when Two Rivers Station motored out to find them. They found nothing. Two bottles washed ashore, allegedly from both captains on board. But this was the fifth ship lost with Christmas trees on board. Why is it that no one can name the others, but the Simmons is one of the most famous Great Lakes shipwreck stories of all time? Part of the reason lies in the media coverage for the Schuneman family, where Chicago's first holiday stories were always delivered when the Simmons pulled through the Clark Street Bridge.
Herman Schuneman was a small player in Christmas trees when he first started out, but he soon became the darling of newspapers like the Chicago Tribune and the Inner Ocean. Soon he was controlling prices on Christmas trees, and Christmas really didn't start until the Christmas tree ship arrived in port in Chicago.
In Bottled Goodbyes, we investigate the messages and the wallet that was supposedly discovered and chronicle all of the ships that followed and how his family used the media to build a near monopoly.
Together with stories from the Titanic, the Milwaukee, the Manistee, and even the Pierre Marquette 18, it's stories of shipwrecks lost and found in Bottled Goodbyes.
Bottled Goodbyes. Find it at your favorite maritime museum or online at lakefury.com.